Agency Swarm can now browse web literally like a real human being with vision. It can not only extract content and click on links and buttons, but also fill out forms, input fields, scroll up and down, go back a page and more. This is the most advanced web browsing agent currently available, but the best part is that you can easily combine it with other agents using my framework Agency Swarm. I will demonstrate exactly how you can do that at the end of this video, but for now, let me just show you this incredible demo. Okay, before we get started, for those who don't know, my name is Arsen and my goal is to automate my whole AI agency with AI. Recently, me and my team launched our first public product called OAI-Widget, and guess what? We needed a QA test engineer who would test staging in production just in case before we go live. So check this out. My agency will consist of just two agents, a quality assurance manager and a browsing agent. The task itself will have 8 steps that we used to do manually, from logging in as a user and creating a new widget to sending a test message and ensuring a response. After I send the instructions, the QA manager immediately communicates the first step to the browsing agent, which is to log in with my provided credentials. Don't even try it. The browsing agent then opens the landing page and encounters the first problem. The login screen is not there. However, it automatically analyzes the page and clicks on a login button, which takes us to the login screen. Now, when the browsing agent tries to enter the credentials again, it succeeds this time and reports to the QA manager that we are in fact logged in. After that, the QA manager sends the next step, which is to create a new widget. This is the cool part about using agent swarms, is that you do not have to instruct your browsing agent on every single step. The QA manager will do that for you instead. The browsing agent again easily performs this task with the click element tool that highlights all the buttons, and then QA manager sends the next step, which is to expand the OpenAI section. I found that providing exact step-by-step process allows your agents to complete it faster. However, alternatively, you can provide more general goals and instruct your manager agent to break them down into step-by-step process for you instead. After our agent expands the OpenAI tab as instructed by the manager, it enters the test API key and selects test assistant, which were the next two tasks. Then it saves the widget by clicking on a save button, which was the following task, and reports back to the manager. Now, only two final steps left. The first one is to send the hello message, which it again executes smoothly with the send keys tool, and the second one is to ensure that the response has been received. The QA manager then finally reports back to me that the tests were performed without any issues, which means that our production is not broken and I can safely go back to sleep. Pretty cool, right? Now, before I explain how these tools are implemented in Agency Swarm and how you can create such a system yourself, I wanted to clarify that this idea of GPT-4 vision-powered web browsing belongs to a YouTuber named Unconventional Coding. AI Jason also showcased this in his video later, but he only changed a few lines of code, just some configuration, and got 10 times more views. So I just wanted to clarify that Unconventional Coding was the one who created this script that marked the elements on the web pages with bounding boxes, allowing GPT-4 Vision to decide which one to click on next. However, that script, in my opinion, had several large limitations. First, it was not fully written in Python and it required Node.js, which made it hard to run and deploy. Second, that script couldn't use any input fields. It could click on buttons, but it was not able to type into search fields or log into websites. And third, it was a closed and non-expandable system, meaning that there was no way to connect more agents and it acted essentially as a standalone chat application. All of these issues are now fully resolved in Agency Swarm with the browsing agent that is fully written in Python, that can click, type and scroll pages, and that you can easily combine with other agents yourself. So let's take a look at how it works and how you can use it. Essentially, browsing agent is just a collection of 7 tools with some special instructions. All of these tools use stealth Selenium browser with Chrome, meaning that you can bypass bot protection on many websites. Read URL, scroll and go back tools are pretty self-explanatory, but the rest of the tools like click element, analyze content, send keys and select drop down is where it gets interesting. All of them use GPT-4 vision under the hood to perform various actions. For example, the Analyze Content tool takes a question from the browsing agent, such as what are the contents of this web page, and then it takes a screenshot of the current browser window and answers it using GPT-4 vision. Tools like Send Keys and Click Element act in a similar fashion. They take a description of the action that needs to be performed on the current web page and then perform it with GPT-4 vision. The cool part about these tools is that they use JavaScript to create bounding boxes and labels around relevant items directly in your web browser window. Therefore, there is no need for any additional libraries. Say, for instance, the browsing agent sends a task to this tool, such as enter an email and password. The bounding boxes then will be only created around the input fields. However, if the task is to click on a login button, a different tool will be used and only the buttons will be highlighted for GPT-4 vision. In case if the element is not located, the prompt instructs GPT-4 vision to give the browsing agent a better idea of where to find it. Of course, there are some things that could be improved, especially if OpenAI releases a few more features, which I will discuss in just a bit, along with some cost implications as many people have requested. Now, let's see how you can make an agent swarm with browsing yourself. So the first step is to install Anaconda or Miniconda from the official website. Then clone the agency swarm repo from GitHub and navigate into the root directory. Create a Conda environment with the following command, then activate it and install Jupyter. Go into the notebooks folder and run Jupyter notebook command. You should see a window pop up in your browser, then click on the web browser agent notebook and run the first cell to install some additional packages. To run my example, you can explore the following cells. However, keep in mind that if you want to test OAI widget, you need to create your own account and provide your own credentials in a task description. What's funny is that sometimes your assistant might refuse to handle personal information, but it happens only rarely and you can typically fix it just by adjusting the prompt. Now, if you want to create your own agent swarm, scroll down a bit to the next section and import the packages. I recommend starting with just two agents and expanding your system as necessary. The more agents you add, the more tasks they will be to handle without your direct supervision. However, keep in mind that this will take longer and also increase the costs. I'll start from the report manager agent, which is responsible for the oversight of the browsing agent's operation. A good practice is to instruct your manager agent to break down tasks into step-by-step process and try to resolve any issues along the way before reporting back. As for the browsing agent itself, you can now simply import it with a single line of code. However, I will also add an additional line to its instructions with my LinkedIn credentials, just in case if he needs to use them. The next step is to create your agency. In this scenario, I will simply allow the report manager to communicate with the browsing agent, but not vice versa. In shared instructions, I will put a couple of goals with some context about my task at hand. Now, the last step is to simply run the demogradio method and send your initial command. Let's test it out. Say I want to compile a report on myself from the top 3 sources on Google. After I send this task, the report manager breaks it down and communicates the first step to the browsing agent, which is to pull up the Google search web page. Then it proceeds to instructing the browsing agent to analyze the top 3 sources one by one, starting with LinkedIn. After it logs in and finds my page, it extracts all the contents, sends them back to the report manager, and then gets the next task, which is to analyze the second page from the AI Accelerator Institute, where I took part as a speaker at one of their generative AI conferences. Again, it easily crawls this page and extracts the relevant content, and then gets the final task, which is to analyze my GitHub profile. After that's done as well, and the report manager has all the required information, it finally compiles a complete and comprehensive report on basically everything that I do. It's quite surprising how much information it has about me already, just from the top 3 search results. Honestly, I might even try to deploy this system in the cloud and run it every time somebody schedules a consulting call with me to prepare. So make sure to schedule if you're interested in agent swarm spying on you. The total cost for this entire scrape were around 67 cents. And for the OpenAI widget test, the costs were around 80 cents. This might be considered a bit high, but in my opinion, if your use case is valuable enough or if you already have someone performing this exact process, it more than justifies the means. However, it is possible to significantly drop these costs if OpenAI releases a few more features. First and foremost, you currently cannot use the vision model in the assistance API, which means that the browsing agent is still somewhat blind and relies on external tools to interpret the website. It works really well already, but when OpenAI adds this model to assistance and allows us to call functions directly with GPT-4V, it will change everything. Secondly, there may be additional tools required. For example, I noticed that it sometimes struggles with pop-ups, so if somebody could contribute a closer pop-up tool, that would be extremely helpful. Lastly, this system could benefit from some form of cookie transferring mechanism that would allow users to transfer cookies from their own browsers. This would eliminate the need for the browsing agent to log in each time. Once again, all contributions are welcome on GitHub and I'll try to review as soon as possible. In the next video, I will attempt to create an agency that generates other agencies because, to be honest, most of the code for the browsing agent was already written by ChatGPT rather than by myself. So it's the only logical next step. And if you want to deploy your agent in production, including those created with Agency Swarm, one of the easiest and most effective ways is to embed it as a chat widget on your or your client's website. You can easily train it to answer customer support tickets, generate leads, or even recommend products. For this, make sure to check out my previous video here where I show you how to do exactly that with our new platform oaiwidget.com. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe.